Life on the Street.
Hola, yo soy Maria, and I love math. Here at BCPS, we use math every day, everywhere, and in every office and school. Come with me, I'll show you how. Today, I'm here with Mr. Crothamill, a teacher of La Educación Física, which is physical education at Lyons Mill Elementary. How do you use math in phys ed?
Well, hello, Maria. Thanks so much for coming by today. Math is integrated in many areas of physical education. To name a few, we use math to measure field sizes, determine averages, calculate Play 60 data, compare fitness gram scores, and calculate our heart rate.
Wow, can you tell me more about how to calculate my heart rate?
Well, of course. During physical activity time, I ask my students to work in their target heart rate zone. In this zone, your body benefits more from your exercise, and it's an intensity level where your heart beats at 60 to 80% of your maximum heart rate. Your maximum heart rate is how fast your heart can beat in 60 seconds or 1 minute. First, we have to determine your maximum heart rate with this calculation, 220 minus your age. Can I ask you how old you are, Maria?
Well, you're never supposed to ask a puppet's age, so let's just say I'm 10.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. Well, great. So your maximum heart rate is 210 beats per minute. Now we need to calculate 60% and 80% of 210. In order to find the percentage of a number, we need to multiply by the percentage and then divide by 100. Here's how we calculate 60% and 80%. 60%, we take 210 times 60, which equals 12,600. And then we take that 12,600, divide it by 100 in order to get 126. For 80%, we take 210 times 80, which equals 16,800. And then we take 16,800, divide by 100, which gives us 168. Now we know, Maria, that your target heart rate zone is between 126 and 168 beats per minute.
Wow, who knew? So how do I know if I'm in my target heart rate zone?
Well, you need to do some more math to determine how fast your heart is beating right now. So that's called your heart rate. First, we take two fingers and we place them gently on our carotid artery in order to feel our pulse. You should be able to feel blood pumping through that artery. We're gonna count our pulse for 15 seconds and multiply that number by 4 to determine our heart rate over 60 seconds. How many times did you feel your pulse, Maria?
I felt it 20 times. If I do the math and multiply by 4, then my heart rate is 80 beats per minute. But wait a minute, my heart rate isn't my target heart rate zone.
So that's a great observation, Maria. That's because we're at rest right now. So if we perform some physical activity, I bet you can get your heart rate in the target heart rate zone. Do you want to try?
Yes, vamos.
So let's check now. How many times did you feel your pulse this time?
40 times, since we counted for 15 seconds and I need to multiply by 4. 40 times 4, my heart rate is currently 160. I made it into my heart rate zone. Thanks for all the math and the exercise.
Thanks for stopping by, Maria. I hope that you can come back again. Can I get a fist bump? All right.